Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. Once again, we're going to do another cocktail out of this little cocktail book, the Floridita Cocktails, published in 1939 in Havana, Cuba. It is a cocktail guide associated with a very, very famous bar, a bar that is credited with the invention of the daiquiri, and a place that Ernest Hemingway hung out all the time. But we're still not going to do the daiquiri recipe, even though there's a bunch of daiquiri recipes in here. This is the very first or the oldest cocktail book that I own that has a tequila recipe in it. Tequila cocktail recipes are very difficult to find in this time period. And tequila in this time period could be, from my reading, horrible. So we're going to try a tequila cocktail using a tequila from today that I know tastes great. And we're going to start out with, it says pure tequila. And I think that speaks to the quality of tequila in this time period. So in this time period, there were no regulations around what could be called tequila or what had to be in tequila. And so I think puro tequila is what you really needed. Next thing, I'm going to use some lemon juice, actually lime juice. It's interesting, again, the Spanish tells you to use lime juice, but the English tells you to do lemon. Next in is some sugar, and I'm adding a super fine sugar so that it dissolves quickly. And then a couple of dashes of Angostura bitters. I like bitters. And so we ice the tin. Give it a shake. And so I've got a couple of Nicanoras here, cooled down. And we will double strain the cocktail. It's a really nice color. Hey, Jules.
Hi, Glen. Hi, friends. What have you got for us today?
So we have a tequila cocktail.
Okay.
From 1939, the oldest tequila cocktail that we have from a bar in Havana, Cuba.
It smells great.
So, yeah.
That's really refreshing.
It is really good, isn't
it? That's like a hot summer day kind of refreshing.
That pool that as soon as I get a shot and I can travel again, that I'm going to be sitting beside in Mexico.
Or a beach or something like that.
Anyway, that's my, I'm dreaming. Sorry. This is one ingredient away from being a margarita.
Huh.
Right? So most margaritas don't have bitters. They'll have Cointreau.
Okay.
And so, you know, you make that substitution and it becomes one of the most famous early tequila cocktails. And so, I don't know. I don't know that it needs the Cointreau. I really like that.
Yeah, it's a really nice, refreshing flavor.
And you play with your tequila, change the tequila, use the tequila that you like, and it's going to be a great drink. I can see this. And it's such a pretty color, too. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.